pie. I wonder if Pubes is his team name. It would be an unfortunate team name, but...
Sign me up. Oh, wait. All right, Calm Before the Storm, and spotting in the bottom right here, we have Future from Team Rain, and he is our blue Protoss playing against our orange Terran, who is Pubes Poop Pie, who will further be known as Triple P, 3P, or Mr. Pie.
Or just anything that...
Or just P.
Just requires...
P Daddy. P Diddy.
Anything.
P Man.
Anything but his actual name, like I said. So,
I know. What is your guys' what's your recommendation in stream? Please let us know.
Yeah, please, please give us a better name
for him. Please give us a name. And if you are just joining us, thank you so much. We appreciate you guys coming and checking us out here on the Tuesdaily. I am Pyronia, and with me is my co-caster, Fegan. We are with RHGaming.com, Relentless Heroes Gaming. Can head on over there. We've got a great community, lots of stuff going on, good things happening. Big shout out to Zeke, our host for the evening, Z33K.com. You can follow them on Twitter at Zeke Gaming. You can follow me on Twitter at Pyronia. And you can follow Fegan on Twitter at Fegan.
That's correct.
Fegan.
I did all these plugs while you're away, by the way.
Oh, you did? Okay, well.
And I gave.
There you go. Better not forget. Go sign up. Follow us. Thanks. Oh.
I did forget to plug Giant Waffle, who's been an excellent admin and really helping out the streamers this week. So
and
big thanks to him.
He received a promotion to be in charge of Zeke TV, so he is going to be stepping up their game a notch and getting you guys Zeke TV events casted almost every day of the week. I think the goal is every day of the week. I'm very excited.
Excellent.
For that.
That should be very fun. I'm looking forward to that a lot. So,
all right,
Mr. Pi is using the pocket expansion. Look at that. Holy
As
crap.
Is Mr. P. So these players both know the map. Woohoo.
Both players are doing it.
I think this might be a first.
Yeah. Like, I love it. We see Zergs expanding down to the natural here. That's completely unsafe. They get bunker rushed. We see Terran trying to expand out here. It's definitely hilarious to see people play this map that have never played it.
But, so, I'm curious to see if Mr. P ends up going the same sort of plan with his mech build.
I think no one plays mech against Protoss.
Well, I'm just curious. I mean, because we haven't seen him play anything else.
Yep. Did you actually cast any of the other games of him while he was away, or is that the first series that you cast of him?
I think it's the first series of him that I casted.
Yeah, I don't think he's going to...
I think we were waiting for him.
I don't think he's going to go mech. Only because mech is super ineffective.
He only has the one gas.
There's only one person who goes mech against Protoss, and it's Goody.
Well, I mean, you know, I don't know. It used to be successful back in the day. You know, I loved it when Jinro went and just, you know, took out MC. Well, you know, I love Jinro. I really wish that Jinro would come back to us and be the good player that we know that he can be.
He's always, he's in Code B and he just always misses it. Like, every time I look, I was like, oh, the preliminaries happened already. Oh, he made it to the finals and lost.
I know, poor guy. All right, so Tech Lab over here. So mech build, but there goes his second gas.
Yeah, I'm very interested to see what we see. Second barracks coming up, so we're definitely not seeing mech. We are seeing pretty much nothing out of Future. Just two gateways that he's croning out some units. Just kind of getting safe, getting his economy up and going.
Ooh, so I like this. Early concussive shells and marauders coming out for Mr. P. I think that's definitely a good move.
Absolutely. I mean, concussive shells are so cheap. They're essentially free.
And they're so annoying.
They are unbelievably annoying. And this Marine is going to deny any sort of scouting from this probe. And we just have the units hanging out at the front of the door for Future. We do have a proxy pylon already up for Future. So we will see if he gets aggressive with that.
Alright, looks like two
robo.
Gate robo here.
Yep. Let's probably just get an observer out, pop some immortals up, probably get safe, take his third, and look to move to Colossi. That is my guess.
Yeah, I think that's definitely a realistic guess. Alright, so we've got a factory going up. Most likely, we'll see a tech lab go or a reactor go down,
yep.
And the starport start building.
There's the starport.
There we go. No reactor, but probably as soon as he gets the
the gas for it.
25 extra gas that he needs. All right, and barracks. So let's see, reactor, tech lab.
Two more gateways being added on for future. Gateway warp gate technology has just finished. Stim is about halfway done, and we have an engineering bay coming up for Mr. Pi.
And Future's doing a nice job of staying ahead in worker count, so he's been consistently ahead of 5, if not more. So right now it's 41 workers to 33.
But we do have the 3 mules, so their income is actually even. With the Terran spiking ahead, mules are pretty ridiculous.
We have a random SCV chilling over here by the starport.
It's just hanging out. It's actually shady.
Another one by the supply depot.
See, it's shady under the starport,
that's
so
true.
He just wanted to take a break. That's all it was.
Smoke break?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, he's had a busy day. Although, they're always just kind of smoking in their little suits anyways, so.
I always wonder, how do they light their cigarettes? I guess they have a little thing in there, but...
I'd assume with the lighter, but
maybe
I could be wrong.
Maybe they have an ashtray, too.
They just let the butts fall.
They're so hardcore that their skin is callous and can just, like, handle the singes.
Yeah, I mean, that's all they do.
It's all just one burn scar.
I mean,
and we're going up to 6 gateways here.
He's working too hard. He can't even be bothered to take it out of his mouth with his hands. He basically just lets the butts fall, flicks it with, like, his tooth or his tongue
just
so they all fall.
He swallows it. He's so hardcore and his lungs are so shot, he just eats them.
Delicious treats.
Mm.
So I am actually partially losing my voice, so hopefully it holds up through the finals. But we have
Yes, I'm hoping I don't get sick.
I was actually sick
Bugs
for...
Bugs are going around from my germ factory that I work at.
I ate a 24-hour bug on Saturday. Probably partly because I was hungover, but I had like a terrible cold. I woke up Sunday morning and it was gone.
All right, so it looks like we have some... pressure plans here from Mr. P.
Yes.
We got a nice little bunch
Marine Marauder,
of
Combat Shield, Stim.
Combat Shield, Stim.
But there are enough sentries. He is probably going to sack this Nexus. Just let the Nexus fall. He's going to try and engage it with his charge lots. Pretty good force fields. Splitting those units up good. We have Starkers being warped in. He is trying to kite them. He does have a good amount of units, so I think the Protoss is going to pull back, and there he goes. He has probably one force field left in him, and he is just waiting for his next warp in. There's a force field trying to just slow down what's happening. Now, there are no pylons left on the low ground, so he's going to have to warp in on the high ground. Ooh, and he lost that warp in.
Ooh, he lost that pylon, yeah. That was a nice...
But it actually looks like he is going to be able to clean this up and not lose the Nexus. All those units are just so low health.
There are reinforcements, sneaking in here, but they're going to be shut down pretty quickly, and I think he's got enough now to clean it up. Yep. He's going to pull back
easily
here.
Clean that up. And Future has actually pulled almost 20 supply ahead as a result of that, and he's going to go in for some pressure now. He does have that proxy pylon. He is going to be able to warp in, and he has a good amount of units. There's only 5 Marines and 4 Marauders left at home for Mr. Pi.
Yep, and he has managed to stay ahead in workers, and he also knew exactly what his opponent was doing because he's had this observer there over
the entire
time of the game. Yeah.
Ghost Academy is coming up. Another command center.
Yep, Ghost Academy up. Good idea. We use
Templar
archives going down, so they're going to be popping at about the same time. Could be seeing some Georgia Archon action. But then we've also got Blink. So we've got a few sort of like backup plans here.
Yep, here come the Templar in, I presume. Yep, it's going right to Archons. It's not going to have enough energy for Sty Storm since they've taken out the amulet like months ago.
I think it's been like
a year at this point.
Now.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
I guess he does have to research Sty Storm too, so.
So that. Okay, looks like we're going to have a pause here.
Oh. So it looks like we have to entertain people.
Well, it's sort of funny. So there were these two little observers here where my screen is. And so he scanned and got one observer, but then he left this other one there. So this observer, I guess, like, was the lucky one. We'll see if he moves before that turret gets built, though.
I really wish spectators could kind of still look around the map when there's a pause, but we unfortunately cannot.
I know.
So we're just going
to
wait.
Okay, so what name do you guys want us to call him?
Hmm?
What name?
Oh, let me see what chat says.
Mr. Papadopoulos.
We got P-Dog, Papadopoulos. Okay, we're back. For Mr. Papadopoulos.
Alright, Mr. Papadopoulos is back.
They picked quite possibly the hardest name for us to actually say, though.
Papadopoulos.
I mean, it's less...
I can say that faster than pubes poop pie.
Okay, fair enough. And we do have the engagement coming in.
Right,
the charge lots are going to be able to get in a good amount of damage, and these Archons are in there, and they're going to rip through this army. Force field on the ramp, stopping any reinforcements. Excellent pickup.
Mr. Papadopoulos' part there. He did a quick little pickup behind his wall.
So Future is continuing to push in. He is still pulling way ahead in supply. Holy crap. Like, this is what happens when you see a pro player playing against in one of these tournaments. He just looks so dominant in this game.
Well, and unfortunately he has just a higher tech army in general, so
he
he's got more things there. He's got Blink, he's got Archons, he's got Templar coming with Storms on their way.
I mean, even holding that...
He has more options here.
Oh no, he's trying to draw, but the army is still there. Can't pick off that medevac, but that they may be ripe for a couple feedbacks.
Mm-hmm.
But
there's
I mean,
not very much energy, though, so...
It'll do some damage. Maybe the Starkers pick it up quickly after that. And he is going to try and go up the ramp again. I assume we're going to see some storms. Excellent feedback on the Ghost there.
Yeah,
that Ghost has been rendered useless. The Guardian Shield goes up, making those units even beefier. And an excellent storm on an entire clump of Marines, and they couldn't even get out of the way. Units are just dropping.
Absolutely out of energy. So, you know, we've got a lot of damaged units and they're just not going to be able to get healed.
No.
In the meantime, we do have
a whole bunch more Zealots coming in and with charge.
Angies, but
I'm sorry.
I don't think they're going to be out of time.
No, they are definitely not. Whole bunch of charge lots coming in and they are able to get into the base. The supply depots have not been picked up and that Archon is doing a ton of damage. He died right before I could check if how many kills he had, but he is a hero Archon in my book.
He is.
Hearing the snipes go down,
snipes.
And it looks like this is going to be held, but all the units are almost dead, so these charge lots are going to be able to rip through these units. And it looks like it's getting pretty close to GG. I mean, the supplies are pretty close to even, but Future has taken additional base on the other side of the map, and he does have an Immortal out now. Just one lone Immortal. No, maybe I was wrong on close to the GG. This army is holding strong for Mr. Papadopoulos. But another warp in of Zealots are coming in. And again, these medevacs are so low on energy, these units are pretty low on health. So it's going to do a ton of damage. Another warp in coming in right into it. Decent split, though.
Blink away.
So,
alright, so it looks like he is going to be able to clean this up, but we do have another tech switch incoming here from...
Yes, Colossi.
...Future, so he's got the Colossi coming up.
No
and
Vikings.
And he does have a hidden fourth up here as well.
No Vikings whatsoever.
And so, that one observer is still there.
It's just hanging out, seeing everything that's happening. So Mr. Papadopoulos is going to push now, and this is going to be... interesting hold. He's going to have to get a couple good storms if he has the energy. If not, he's just going to have to do some good damage. I mean, he is only up by 7 in supply, which is very interesting.
Well, unfortunately, he doesn't have the energy for storm here.
No. So he's making an Archon. His Archon is being pushed into safety, but it does eventually go down. But this is actually a terrible situation for him. I think he's going to lose his third. Does have a Colossi up, though. He's just waiting for that tech to finish, but he doesn't have a lot to guard that Colossi, so he's going to have to get some excellent micro...
Unfortunately, he lost his portals earlier.
He did. But that Colossi is still doing a good amount of damage, but he is going to lose a lot of stuff in this engagement.
Mm-hmm.
And the Terran has pulled ahead in supply.
He might actually lose his robotics bay. Yep, there he goes. And Thermalance was not finished.
No, it was not.
And he lost his... Ooh, both of his robotics.
A very good storm there, though.
Yeah, unfortunately, he just lost so much tech there.
Yeah, this is going to be tough. I mean, all those units are so close to dead, so when the charge cooldown is up, it's going to do a ton of damage. There's almost no energy left in that medevac. And
a lot of reinforcements streaming across the map here.
A fifth secret base has been taken by Future.
Yeah, unfortunately, right now, he just needs more production facilities.
He needs...
I mean, he has money, but he just can't really spend it right now.
Yep. I'd really like to see him drop a force field on the ramp to buy himself some more time.
Yeah, I think that would have been a good idea. He definitely has the gas to hit a bunch of sentries, so he could have been doing that for quite a while. I mean, I guess...
He's really just holding back and staying patient, getting an army that can break this push. And he's doing a lot of damage with those charge lots, and the Archons are up, and everything is so low, the Archons are going to start to rip through it, but they are doing so much damage. 3-3 is about to complete, and the Archons and Zealots are 3-1-1.
Yeah, I think we did some more upgrades there, too. That would have helped. Okay, we've got an Immortal about to pop. I don't think it's me enough.
Yeah, I mean, it's really back and forth, bit by bit. Those reinforcements streaming in are huge, but it looks like he's finally cleaned up the majority of the push. He's just got the reinforcements streaming in, which are large in number, though. But I think this...
Oh, and he doesn't know about the other bases.
No, he has no idea.
He's got tech going up on those, too. You know, so the thing is here, if Future's able to sort of stabilize here, you know, Rain's gonna...
He's going to be in
Mr. P's going to think that he's way far ahead.
Exactly.
Compared to where he actually is. And if you look at income, Future's still ahead by 11 workers.
And he's producing twice as much minerals and basically a third more gas. So he's definitely going to be far ahead. And here come the scouts. He is sending Marines across the map to look for secret expansions. But he's going to see them and say, oh god, these have been up forever.
Yeah.
But he thinks he's about to put the nail in the coffin. But look at all these units streaming out. Excellent EMP to a whole bunch of Clumb Zealots on the ramp. But more warp-ins are coming in. A whole bunch of High Templar, so we're going to see a ton more Archons. And these charge lots are just doing so much work. They are up to 2 damage now, but the Bio Army is up to 3-3 still. But there's a lot of work being done. Those Immortals.
Immortals doing a nice job.
Yeah, the Immortals are heroic. And he's finally cleaning up those medevacs with the Stalkers and Archons, which is huge, so that they can't heal up what little they can. So it looks like Future is actually starting to push out on this. He's doing a good amount of damage. Here come some Ghosts in, though. He needs to watch out for the EMPs. Oh, EMP on the Stalker, not on the Archon, which is actually really interesting.
Well, I think the Archons were down far enough, and looks like he's going to be heading up here to some of the expansions. And there's not a lot here at the expansion to guard. So
no, he's got a couple cannons, but there's not a ton of units there. I mean, there's the one High Templar that's been hanging up there to feedback any drops that come in, and a whole bunch of Zealots were just warped in there. So he's actually going to be able to hold this pretty well. There's the pickup just to get the units away. And there he goes, and a whole bunch of probes just ran by after that engagement. And that medevac is... Oh, how much health does that have? That has 1 health left. If he gets a feedback off on that, that is going to fit. There we go, a Stalker shot. So it looks like this game has stabilized again, and Future is pulling way ahead. He looked to be in dire straits there, but he was patient.
Well. He held it together.
He was unbelievably patient. That was like brilliant, brilliant poise. And now he is pushing into the natural.
A little bit of counterattack action here. So we've got Future going into Mr. P's base, and at the same time, we've got a little group of infantry going over into the main of Future as well.
He has a whole bunch of Zealots there that should be able to hold this. He's warping in a bunch more. So I think this is going to be perfectly fine. And the engagement at the main is going to do a ton of damage, and... Now the supplies are really starting to spread, and I think this is going to be pretty close to GG.
Yeah, I think so. I think having the upper right-hand corner and being able to just sort of maintain and stabilize and push off just enough is really what Future needed to do to win him this game.
Absolutely. I mean, he basically just held as to the last inch, and then he had his 3 expansions, which allowed him to pull way ahead once that is happening. In the last act of desperation, Mr. Papadopoulos is sending his units into the third, picks off a High Templar, but one storm is pretty much just going to clear everything up here, and it looks like it